What's up, guys? I got my Hawaiian shirt on. I bought a guitar. I might be going through a midlife crisis, but more importantly, Apple's holding a new event on October 30th. The event we have all been waiting for, it is finally happening. I'm so excited for this event, and I'm happy that we're going to see new iPads, new Macs, and maybe some other stuff as well. So let's go ahead and talk about everything we can expect to see and when the event is starting. All right, so first off, the invitations are incredible this year. I think Apple sent out a slightly different Apple logo in a number of the invitations. I'm sure they repeated some, but over on their website, I'll have this website linked down below where you can watch the live stream starting at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on October 30th. You'll be able to refresh and get a different Apple logo. Is this cool? This is so neat. So creative. Huge fan of the way this looks, and you get a super cool looking Apple logo every time. I think there's like a total bin or like cache of maybe 10 or 12, but keep refreshing. Maybe Apple will be adding some leading up to the event. I just found this on Twitter. Apparently there are 32 different logos, which is crazy. Apple put a ton of time and effort into designing these, and it definitely makes me excited for the event. Maybe they're teasing Apple Pencil 2 capabilities. We have heard that a second generation Apple Pencil could be coming for the new iPad Pros, and that's where I wanna start. These devices are going to be the headlining products announced. New Macs are coming as well. I'll jump into that in a second, but new iPad Pros with edge-to-edge displays, one at either 10.5 or 11 inches, the other one normally at 12.9 inches, are going to be announced, and they are going to look something like this. We've actually seen some new renders or images of how they could look leak recently from, I think, some case manufacturers, and the more I see this device, the more I want to get my hands on it. This is going to be a notchless device, which means the new Face ID camera system, because it will not have Touch ID. The new iPads are going to have Face ID, just like the iPhone X, XS, and XS Max. They're able to fit it into the bezel because rather than Apple making the bezels crazy thin, like on the iPhone X models, for example, they're going to be a little bit thicker, but even all the way around. And honestly, I think that was the best decision Apple could have made here. I'm usually a fan of more screen, but a notch on an iPad, especially something just sticking out of the screen like this far, I think it would definitely look a little bit strange. So it's going to be an even bezel all the way around. And based on these renders, I think Apple made the right choice here. There's also gonna be some crazy other features as well. We've been hearing USB-C functionality. And more than just being a USB-C port, it is said to feature 4K HDR output support. So that means this iPad Pro is going to be able to power a very good looking image output. 4K HDR is pretty impressive, but I also feel like that's a standard here. And if Apple does want to shift the iPad into more of a computer than a traditional tablet, being able to output your screen to an external display, crazy theory, maybe connect like a mouse or keyboard, that would definitely be a game changer for the iPad Pros. But absolutely, Apple has marketed the iPad Pros as a computer replacement for a very long time. It makes sense that they are finally putting a computer grade port on there. I don't think Lightning, the one on the iPhone or traditionally the iPad, is going to be the port of the future. It's Apple's proprietary technology, and for integration with a number, thousands, maybe even millions of third-party accessories, Apple is going to want to use USB-C so that iPad can be a viable computer replacement. Now, just recently, 9to5Mac actually updated one of their articles with more information about this iPad Pro. I think they said sources have been feeding them little tidbits about this device. We now know what kind of processor this device is going to have. This device is going to be the most powerful iOS device ever that Apple has ever made, that Apple has ever touched, that the public has ever seen. Also probably going to be the fastest mobile processor ever released. You guessed it, it is going to be the A12X. And it's gonna be incredible. Like, the A12 is already, I believe right now, the fastest processor on the market. And for Apple to even make it more powerful with better CPU processing, 9to5Mac also says there's going to be a faster A12X GPU as well. So this computer is going to be a beast. Obviously, to power things like 4K HDR video, you need a really great processor inside. So that's what Apple's done here, and I am so excited to see the benchmarks from this processor. I'm blown away by the performance on my iPhone XS, and if Apple takes that another step up just a month and a half after announcing the iPhone XS, I cannot imagine the kind of power that you'll be able to get out of this iPad for really complex things like Photoshop. A few days ago, this is actually huge news for the iPad becoming more of a computer replacement. Adobe announced that in 2019, so next year, Full versions, I believe, of Photoshop are going to be coming to the iPad Pro line. I can almost guarantee Apple will talk about this on stage, maybe even preview how it looks and works on the new iPads, because it's gonna be, I think, a game changer. Up until this point, I guess you have Infinity Photo or Infinity Designer, but Photoshop has never been in its full form available on the iPad. On top of this new iPad, I definitely think that will be the main part of this event. If you've been looking to get a new Mac Mini, iMac or MacBook Air, you are in luck. So first up, the Mac Mini. Dad, I know you're watching. The Mac Mini is going to get an update on October 30th. It is all but confirmed. The Mac Mini has not been touched in 4 years. That is an absurd amount of time in the computing industry, really an absurd amount of time in general for technology updates as a whole. It is finally going to be seeing a pro-focused upgrade, which is so good to hear. I have wanted to see a Mac Mini upgrade for a while because a lot of people don't want to buy an iMac for like $2,000-ish, $1,500. They might already have a keyboard, mouse, and monitor, and they just want some good Apple hardware. And that's exactly what the Mac Mini is. I can't wait to get this device. I'm definitely going to try to get my dad to pre-order one so I can do a video on it, because I think it's going to be a fantastic machine and it needs an upgrade. 4 years is just too long. All right, next up, the MacBook Air. This device is also in desperate need of some major upgrades. It is said that this year, in just a few days at Apple's October event, it's going to get a pretty big upgrade. Said to go on sale for sub $1,000, which I always get a little sketched out on pricing rumors, but I can hope that will be the case. The MacBook Air is said to finally get a Retina display with slimmer bezels. Now, when I hear slim bezels, I instantly go to like an edge-to-edge screen. I do not think that will be happening on any of the Macs this year. So, MacBook Air getting a big upgrade, said to be pretty cheap, and I'm just so happy to finally get a Retina display on that device, because it's needed one for a while and it has not had one ever, and it's also a pretty good product. It's unclear at this point what this new MacBook is going to be called. I'm assuming it's going to be called the MacBook Air. A lot of rumors and leaks have indicated that that will be the case, but it could just be a new version of the 12-inch MacBook. We don't entirely know. We just know a new low-price MacBook is coming with slim bezels and a Retina display, and that sounds really good, especially if you're looking for a cheaper Apple laptop. On top of those two, we are also going to be seeing new iMacs. No significant upgrades are said to be happening in this department, but I think it's definitely going to be time soon. Apple just released the iMac Pro. We haven't heard anything about updates for that. We know the new Mac Pro is coming in 2019, so I could see Apple updating the iMac Pro and Mac Pro at a pro-focused event sometime, and maybe early to mid to late, just sometime next year. So the iMacs this year at this Apple event, I have a feeling Apple's just gonna get up on stage and say, maybe we made the screen a little bit better. Obviously the processors will be getting an upgrade, maybe some price cuts if we're lucky. So as of right now, we don't know of any significant upgrades, but who knows, maybe Apple could have something up their sleeves that has not leaked. So overall, new Mac's gonna be great. A new Mac Mini, a new iMac, and a new MacBook Air. Maybe another new Pro display sprinkled in there as well. We don't exactly know, but for sure, those three new Macs are coming, and of course, two new iPad Pro models as well. So it's going to be a packed event. Apple Pencil 2 also said to be getting a refresh. Where things get sketchy is with these two products right here. So you know the first one. I've talked about it for over a year now, and I am so tired and so done with AirPower. It is the wireless charging mat that Apple teased a year ago that they say is coming, that they promised would be coming before the end of 2018. But according to some reports, doesn't look like it's doing so great anymore. So conflicting reports have said it is coming. Other reports have said it's definitely not going to happen. Maybe it gets canceled in its entirety. If we don't see AirPower, I can only hope that we'll see a second gen version of AirPods, because it will almost be 2 years since AirPods were announced. And I love my first gen versions. I just would like to see what other features Apple can add. A really long time ago, Bloomberg reported that the second gen version of AirPods would be coming this year in 2018, and they would be receiving Hey Siri functionality. Sorry to set up all your devices, but basically hands-free functionality to where you wouldn't have to double tab. You could just say the trigger phrase. But since we haven't heard anything for a while, I wouldn't be surprised if we just saw an over-the-air AirPods software update. It feels like Apple could add that Siri trigger functionality hands-free without giving you a second piece of hardware or without having to buy new AirPods. So We don't really know about that as well. With the AirPower, with AirPods, that's where things get sketchy. But what you can count on, new iPads and new Macs, they are coming. And I'm interested if Apple puts some music spin on this event as well, because they're holding it at an opera hall. I just feel like because Apple's holding it in a very, very different location, that they would definitely maybe have opera singers there or some kind of music focus. Because why would they be holding it at a special opera hall in Brooklyn when they could just do the event literally anywhere because they're Apple, but also at their home campus in Cupertino. All right, that's all I have for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hit like if you enjoyed it, hit subscribe for more. I've been Sam, I hope you're doing great, and I'll talk to you in my next video.